All right, welcome back. So I couldn't help myself. I have to do another phase portrait. This one is one of my absolute favorite kind of dynamical systems to play around with, is the particle in this quartic or fourth order potential well, given by this formula here. My potential function is a fourth order polynomial minus a second order polynomial. And again, by Newton's second law, we can write down that the dynamics x double dot are minus the gradient of this potential. So that should be a positive x minus an x cubed. So x minus x cubed. And I'm just going to put in kind of almost like air quotes here, this optional, you know, minus, this is like an optional friction or damping, okay? And so I'm actually gonna draw the phase portrait with and without friction. So, you know, at first we're gonna ignore this friction, this x dot, this damping or friction. I'm gonna draw the phase portrait, and then I'm gonna draw it again with the friction. So I'm actually gonna put my axes up here, because I think I need, maybe I'll just put, okay, good, good, yes. Okay, and I'm gonna draw my phase portrait, x, v, and x, v, kind of without friction. And then I'm gonna do it again with friction. So this is with friction. And these are going to make some super cool pictures. These are absolutely beautiful. We've actually made t-shirts. My wife and I have made t-shirts of the phase portrait of this dynamical system. That's how cool it is. Okay, good. And like I do, we're going to turn this into a system of coupled first order equations instead of a second order equation. So we're going to introduce x dot equals v. I probably shouldn't do pink here. It doesn't really matter. I'm not going to do pink here. I'm going to do blue to stay consistent. So x dot equals v, and v dot equals x minus x cubed. And again, there will be this optional, you know, minus v term that we're going to add. And it's probably not minus v. I might make this minus 0.01 x dot or minus 0.01 v, just so you can draw your pictures a little bit more sensibly if you actually want to do this at home. Okay. And so what we do is we find our fixed points, we find the Jacobian, the linearization of these nonlinear dynamics at those fixed points, and that tells me locally what the dynamics are going to look like. So again, from first principles physics, I know that I'm going to have a fixed point at the top of this hill. If I put my particle or my bead, okay, we're talking about a little particle that's rolling around on this potential surface, or a little bead that's kind of sliding along this wire surface here. And so if I started at this point here, I would stay there forever. It's a fixed point. Now, if I pushed it, if I nudged it, it's going to roll off. But if I was perfectly balanced, that's a fixed point. That's a fixed point, and that's a fixed point. So I'm going to just draw these down, because we know already that they're going to look like this. Probably shouldn't have gone all the way down here, but that's life. Okay, and I'm just going to write down what my fixed points are. So my fixed points, of course, v is going to have to equal 0 for this to be a fixed point. So v is always going to have to equal 0. And I know I have three fixed points. I'm just going to write them out. In all of these cases, v has to equal 0. And if v equals 0, then x minus x cubed has to equal 0. So the easiest way for that to happen is for x to equal 0. That's definitely a fixed point. This is the x equals 0 fixed point right here. So x equals 0, v equals 0 is a fixed point. But if x equals plus or minus 1, this also equals 0. So plus 1 and minus 1, plus 1 and minus 1 are also fixed points. This is, you know, plus 1, this is minus 1. Those are also fixed points of x with velocity equal to 0. So those are our three fixed points. We compute our Jacobian matrix df dx. This is my vector field, you know, f of x and v. So df with respect to that vector, I call this, I'm calling this little xv stacked vector x underbar. So the derivative of f with respect to x is this Jacobian matrix. Partial of the first equation with respect to x is 0. Partial of the first equation with respect to v is 1. Partial of the second equation with respect to x is 1 minus 3x squared. And partial of the second equation with respect to v is minus 1 if I have friction, 0 if I don't. Okay, it would be 0 if I don't have friction, it would be minus 1 if I do have friction, or minus 0.01 or 0.001. Whatever I say the magnitude of this friction term is going to be what's down here. I shouldn't have smudged that. Should not have smudged that. Okay. And now, the last thing, this is, okay, not so bad. I found my fixed points. I computed the Jacobian. Now I have to evaluate this Jacobian at each of these fixed points and find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay, so I'm just going to write this down. This is pretty simple. So at the 0, 0 point, df dx at my 0, 0 point is going to be 0, 1, 1, and again, optionally, if I have friction, a negative 1 here. If not, it'll be 0. And in either case, we're going to get saddle dynamics for this point. This point's going to be a saddle, okay, which totally makes sense because it's unstable. If I nudge the system, it's going to go unstable. And you could compute its eigenvectors and eigenvalues. You know, you could do that. And the eigenvectors are going to be pointing in the 45 degree direction with these ones unstable and these ones stable. I'm skipping some steps. You could, you know, do this in Python or MATLAB or by hand to find these eigenvectors. And so these eigenvectors are pointing in this direction here. I know for these mechanical F equals MA systems, usually my saddles are in this 45 degree orientation. And then both of the other points actually have exactly the same linearization Jacobian because x squared, whether I plug in plus 1 or minus 1, this x squared is the same. So df dx at either plus or minus 1, 0, either of those points, is going to equal 0, 1. And now 1 minus 3 is minus 2. And then again, this optional, you know, friction could be here or not. And I really should have called this like, you know, 0.01 x dot, 0.01 v, minus 0.01, minus 0.01, minus 0.01. I'm just lazy. But when you actually compute this, use a small number here so it doesn't botch your eigenvalues too much. And I'm going to claim that this, with no damping, so with no damping, this is going to have plus or minus you know, some constant I, you know, some number times I. So this is going to be a center, a stable center. Or with friction, it's going to be a spiral sink with friction. Meaning I'm going to have like a minus A plus or minus I for my eigenvalues. I'm going to have a negative real part plus or minus I. Complex conjugate part with damping, with friction. And so now I'm actually ready to draw these phase portraits. So I'm going to start with the no friction case because that'll be a lot easier, the without friction case, where this fixed point, these two fixed points are just pure centers. There's no friction, so they just, you know, a little particle is going to oscillate forever in these wells. And so in that case, these are going to be concentric little circles. And I'm pretty sure that the direction of the arrows go here. If I remember from my last lecture, they go like this. Similarly, concentric circles here, like that. Meaning that if I start with a little particle that's a teeny bit up this well, it's just going to oscillate back and forth forever. That's what this XV diagram having a circle means, is that, you know, X is decreasing while V increases, then X, in, you know, if I start here at zero velocity, then x is going to move in the right direction. X is going to move in this right direction, and velocity is going to pick up. Velocity is going to hit its maximum value here at the fixed point version of at where x is at the fixed point. And then it's going to overshoot. X is going to increase until v eventually is zero at the top of this. And then it's going to turn around and do the same thing. Okay, so these totally make sense. And down here, the only thing that's going to change is that now these centers are no longer perfect circles. They are going to kind of, how do I want to draw this? They're going to, you know, spiral inward like that. And these guys are going to, how do I want to draw it? These guys are also going to spiral inward like that. That's the only thing that's going to change. But now again, this is all that I can say from the local linearization, from just taking these Jacobians and evaluating locally. We're zooming in near these fixed points where these nonlinear dynamics look linear, and this is what the local linearization looks like. But the nice thing is that we can actually infer more about the global structure because of the physics of the system. And usually I start with the saddle point and I think to myself, what happens if I nudge this thing a teeny bit to the right? So it's basically going to roll down this hill. It's going to go up to the same height here. I'm just going to draw myself a line so I don't mess up like last time. Same thing if I did it here. If I nudged it a teeny bit to the left, it's going to roll up this hill to the same height. And what that means is that this trajectory is going to kind of go until x is at this point here, where I have zero velocity because I've come to the same potential energy. Then it's going to turn around and go right back the way it came, perfectly symmetrically back like this. And this is called the unstable manifold of this fixed point because this is the unstable direction. This is, and it's curved, so it's a manifold. And it attaches to the stable manifold. It'll kind of come back, and there's a perfect trajectory with a perfect position and velocity that will roll right up exactly to that fixed point. That's this blue curve here. Similarly, if I nudge it to the left, I get the same thing in reverse like that. And the last piece I want to draw is, what if I had my point here, but I pushed it with a bigger velocity? I gave it like a big initial kick. So I start at this x location, but at a big positive velocity. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to overshoot to a farther point. So I'm going to overshoot to a farther point. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to pass right through my fixed point with a negative velocity. I'm going to turn around and pass right through my fixed point with a negative velocity. And then I'm going to overshoot to another point on the left. And then I'm going to repeat that forever and ever and ever. So this is another orbit where if I have a little bit more energy than this fixed point, I'm just going to go around and around forever and ever. So this is the global orbit structure for this double well potential, for this double potential well. And when I add friction, the only thing that changes is that these stop being perfect centers and they spiral in. The kind of symmetry breaks and now they spiral in. And now I believe that this, if I nudge my system from this perfect fixed point, it will roll up to a little bit less high, then it'll roll to a little bit less high, and eventually it'll get trapped in this well. And similarly, if I kick it to the left, it'll eventually get trapped in this left well. So if I kick it to the right, I am going to eventually kind of get sucked into this well. If I kick it from the left, I'm eventually going to get sucked into this well. And I get this kind of cool spiral pattern here. And then you can continue these out just by logic. It has to be like this, which I really like, drawing this kind of candy cane stripe pattern here. And so this actually segments phase space, the XV space. Every single point I start with, eventually, after friction, after enough time, after it oscillates enough, will either land and die in one of these well or the other, either this well or this well. And so you can almost kind of reverse back and figure out what, you know, all of the points that ended up in this well, I'm just going to draw them in pink, all of the points that ended up in this well here form this stripe of the system. Let's try not to mess this up. This stripe here. All of these points will eventually end up in this left well that I've drawn in pink. And all of these points that I'm going to draw in blue, I'm going to just emanate outward from this blue point. All of these points are going to end up in the red well, in the right well. The right well, not the red well. Does that make sense? So eventually, there is this whole kind of interesting candy stripe landscape of points that will eventually go to either the left well or the right well. So these are kind of called attracting basins, these two basins of attraction, and all trajectories are eventually going to end up at these two fixed points. Very, very cool. This is the one we made a t-shirt of. My wife made a really cool Photoshop of the scream face. So let's see if I can do this without botching it too terribly. Yeah, the scream face in the middle of phase space. So no one can hear you scream in phase space. All right, so that's phase portraits. This is one of my favorite dynamical systems, and you can do a lot of powerful stuff even for very nonlinear systems by finding the fixed points, linearizing around the fixed points, looking at the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and, you know, using your intuition and geometry. All right, thank you.